The basics of using a digital SLR camera. This video shows how to use the aperture, shutter speeds, and ISO settings. This is the LCD panel where most of the settings will take place. Aperture, shutter speed, and ISO settings. Here is the mode control dial. Most people set this to auto to make life easier. But we will set this now to AV, aperture priority. This gives you full control over the aperture and the camera takes care of the shutter speed. Setting the aperture. The aperture refers to the lens opening and how much light is let in. By adjusting the aperture value, you adjust the diameter of the lens. Aperture is measured in f-stops, focal ratio. Confusingly, the larger the f-stop number, the smaller the diameter, and the less light is let into the camera. The smaller the f-stop, the larger the diameter, and the more light is let in. The lens we are using is a 24-105 zoom lens. For the first demo, we will set this to 105. This is the rotary toggle control for adjusting the aperture. Let's toggle through from F4 to F22, a small aperture. Right, let's take some shots. Just get focus. At F22, you will find the whole shot is in focus, looking very bland. I will take the shot again at F4.5, a large aperture. Right, just focus again. Now the background is out of focus, giving prominence to the main subject, a far more pleasing image. Now take a look, right down to the end of the garden. The whole background is out of focus, pulling the attention to the yellow flower head. Now we come to depth of field and how we can control it with f-stops. Notice the point of focus. This demonstration is across 9 meters. The first setting is at f22. Then f11. See how the depth of field is changing as we open up the aperture. F8. And right down to F4. Now you can see how the shallow depth of field was achieved in this shot at F4. Here is another example at 6.3. Notice the point of focus on this guitar. At F22, the whole picture is in focus, right out to the edge. Now at F4, the depth of field is much shallower and brought right down to just the point of focus area. In this portrait, be aware of the changes in the background at F22, F11, and the final at F4. Let's take a closer look through from F22 to F4. For the next few shots, we will set the lens to 24mm. And take the aperture down to f22, a small aperture, an ideal setting for landscapes. At f22, focus is sharp right through from the foreground to the horizon, a great aperture setting for a vast depth of field. This diagram shows depth of field clarity by using f4, f8 and f22. You may need to pause at this stage to study this. Setting the shutter speed. We will now change the mode from AV to TV. That's shutter priority, time value. This allows you to set the shutter speed and the camera takes care of the aperture. The speed of the shutter affects the amount of time that the light is allowed to enter the camera. Here are two examples, one at 200th of a second and one at 15th of a second. A slow shutter speed will give motion blur, whereas a fast shutter speed freezes the action. Here is the shutter speed on the LCD. You can toggle through from slow speed to fast speed. I will take this back to 500th of a second, a moderately fast speed. 500 was fast enough to capture this goose landing on the canal, but still retains that motion in the spray of water. At 640, I was able to capture this pan shot of a heron in flight. At 125, this pan shot of a Mercedes SLK was not possible. But at 1300, the action has been frozen and the detail has been retained. A word of warning, your camera must be on a tripod when using a shutter speed of 30 and below. That's to avoid camera shake. Switching on the image stabilizer on your lens will also help, if your lens has one. A slow shutter speed gives motion blur, sometimes enhancing the shot and making the water look soft. The same shot at 1250 has frozen the water and brought out the detail in each drop of water. I will now toggle down to 13 seconds. That's not 13 inches as it may look. It is 13 seconds. The camera needs to be on a tripod as the lens will be open for 13 seconds. Slow shutter speeds are in general used at night or in low light situations. ISO, adjusting sensitivity. ISO relates to the camera sensor and the sensitivity that is allocated to it, very similar to the conventional ASA of a film camera. As a general rule of thumb, you should set this to 100 or 200 when taking shots outside. If it is overcast or in the evening, then increase the ISO to 1600. However, a high ISO can also leave the picture with a grainy effect called digital noise. The next shot will demonstrate the effects of digital noise or grain. At 200, this shot is very clean and sharp. The same shot, 6400, gives a very different look. As we zoom in, you can see the digital noise created by the high ISO of 6400. Let's go back to a few original pics. The shot of the heron and how all the settings together created the final image. The shutter speed was 640, aperture f8 and the ISO 1250. Again with this night shot. A shutter speed of 13 seconds with an aperture of f22 and the ISO was set at 400. You can now see how these three individual settings combine to give you the perfect balanced exposure. Thanks for watching. I hope that this video has made you more aware of aperture, shutter speeds and ISO. Next time we will switch to full manual control,